out for 45 minutes to an hour just to make the blending process easier. Also, I have here, I'll need another egg, but I'm going to use 8 eggs for this recipe for the block of cream cheese and the stick of butter. Rule of thumb is to use 8 eggs for this egg loaf. So I'll grab another egg in a second. Then my final ingredient here is the ground cinnamon. That is the topper for this recipe, and I'll also blend this. And before I add this butter and the eggs and the cream cheese, I'm gonna just use this stick of butter to kind of coat the baking pan. I have a Pyrex dish here. This is an 8 by 11 inches. This is perfect for this recipe. So what I'm gonna do is just simply take this butter and just kind of grease the glass dish here, so it doesn't stick when we're baking. So I'm just gonna do this, and that way that just saves a step. So I can use the remainder just to add in the blender. So that's evenly coated. Just try to get a little bit on the sides as well. So it just, when it cools, it just cuts so easily. So I have this all greased here. And then the rest of it here, we're gonna get ready to blend. Okay guys, we are ready to blend. You see here, I added my extra eggs, so I have a total of 8 eggs. So I am going to just add these, let me move this over, to the blender here, all 8 of those. Move these over here, make it easier. And it seems like it's a lot, but this is a great meal. Breakfast or lunch of protein filled, and it tastes just like French toast. It's one of our favorites here. Definitely I'll fix this for my fiance during the week for his breakfast to take to work, and definitely a weekend substitute. You know, a lot of times we love our Cracker Barrel and IHOP, but this is a healthier alternative and definitely a keto approved and low carb friendly. So definitely a great substitution. You will not be disappointed. So this is egg number 8. I'll clean that up. Now I'm gonna add my, and I've opened this up just to kind of save time, the block of cream cheese. I'm just gonna drop that in, as well as my stick of butter. And this is the butter that I used to grease the Pyrex pan. So I'm just gonna add that in there as well. Get a napkin here, my fingers are a little greasy. And then last but not least is the ground cinnamon. And I do not use measurements for this. I love cinnamon. So I'm just gonna add, I'd say estimated maybe a half of a teaspoon, but you can use more if you would like. Okay, all the ingredients are in, guys, and we're ready to blend. Check this, and kind of, if you want to, you can scrape the sides. Let me go in here, pull me out a spoon. I can use my wooden spoon here. And I see a little bit of the cinnamon on the side kind of sticking, so I may give it a little stir here. Make sure it's all blended up before we transfer to the Pyrex dish. So we're gonna give this one more blend. We are good to go here. It smells good too. I smell cinnamon. Love cinnamon. Okay guys, so what I'm gonna do here, let me adjust here so you can see. I am just gonna take this mixture and pour into the greased Pyrex dish here. So I'm just gonna simply pour this in. Get all of it out. All right, then I'll rinse this in a minute. But I'm just gonna make sure that this is just, you know, just shake it a little bit. I don't like to hit glass too much, but that's all. And the final step here, guys, is to sprinkle the cinnamon here on top. I love this dish. And I like a lot of cinnamon, as you can see. This tastes just like French toast. You'll have to try it and let me know what you think. So I'm gonna place this in for 40 minutes. All right, guys, this is the finished product. It smells heavenly. That cinnamon, it smells up this kitchen and I'm just ready to dive into it. But you must try this, guys. I'll let this cool for about 10 minutes and then I'll just, you know, cut through those in squares. Maybe it should make about, I would say 8, you know, maybe if you want larger pieces, 6 slices, but it is so good. You can just eat it plain with a side, you know, of your bacon or whatever you want to eat with it. But I drizzle a little bit of sugar-free maple syrup on top of it. It tastes just like French toast. You'll love it. That's all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more delicious recipes. And I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.